Hello children, how are you all? Hope everyone is fine at home and you are all enjoying these classes and learning good. Okay children, and you are bored of having these equations and solving equations, framing equations, isn't it? So today we are going to have a small change. Don't think that the change is for the whole session, just a change in the beginning. Okay. Here is a trick for you, and you have to find what trick it is. Okay, I have arranged the numbers from 1 to 16 in this table. Okay, what you have to do now is think of a number. Think of a number. I may not know what number you are going to think. Each and everyone will think different numbers. Okay. Now, second step is think second number. For example, if I have thought of this number 3, I have to leave all the numbers along this row 3, 7, 11 and 15. I should leave out these fully and also these fully. And remaining, I have some numbers now. In that, I have to think a number. Okay. It can be any number, my dear children. Number 1 and number 2. Have you thought of the second number? Yes. Similarly, think of third number also, and that number should not lie in the row and column of first number and second number. If I have thought of second number, I have should not think a number that lies in the same in that column and also in that row. So you will have remaining 4 numbers alone to think of that. Is it clear? Okay. Similarly, choose another number 4. That fourth number should not lie in the rows and columns of all the previous 3 numbers together. So now you have chosen 4 numbers. Each and every one of you would have chosen different numbers. But remember, you should follow that condition. When you choose a number, it should not lie in the row or column of the previously chosen number. Okay. Now, add up all these 4 numbers. Add all the 4 numbers that you have chosen. Have you all added? Yes. Now, your answer will be 34. Am I right? Now, find what trick is behind this trick. Okay. Okay, children. Shall we get into today's session? Okay. The first question is, Arjun is twice as old as Shreya. 5 years ago, his age was 3 times Shreya's age. Find their present age. Today we are going to deal with all the application oriented problem which is about age. Okay. Now here we have two names, Arjun and Shreya. Arjun is twice as old as Shreya. That is, Shreya is younger, Arjun is elder. Okay. And they have given 5 years ago also. I prefer, let us tabulate the given data in a table format. Okay. Twice in the sense, 2 times as old as Shreya. So you will have 2x present age. 5 years ago, what does mean by ago? Before or after? Yes, it is 5 years ago means before. Before we will have age to be less or more? Yes, we will have age to be less. So, Arjun's age will be minus 5. And Shreya's age will be x minus 5. Do you understand now? Yes. See here, after 5 years ago, this his age, Arjun, his in the sense Arjun. Arjun's age was 3 times Shreya's age. 3 times Shreya's age. Now I will write it in a table format. Present age is x of Shreya. Arjun's age is twice, so 2x. And 5 years ago, so it is x minus 5. And here you will have 2x minus 5. You will write 2x minus 5. And this 2x minus 5 is equal to, they are saying this after 5 years ago, Arjun's age is 3 times. So 3 into Shreya's age. What is Shreya's age before 5 years ago? It is x minus 5. So be clear while you write this equation. So I got an equation 2x minus 5 is equal to 3 times x minus 5. Now it is simple for you to solve this equation. How will you solve it? Remove the bracket by multiplying the factor. So you will have 2x minus 5 is equal to 3x. 3 5s are 15. Then you have to rearrange the components in this equation. All these terms that has x has to be shifted over to a left hand side. And the numbers has to be shifted over to right hand side. See here, this is how we do. But here they have done, I have done it in a different way. Just to introduce a method where it is not a method, it's the same thing. Where we will have variables in the right hand side and numbers on the left hand side. Both are right. Is it clear? If I transpose this 3x, it will come as minus 3x here. See here, I will do though even that 2x minus 3x, isn't it? Here I will have minus 15 already. I will have minus 15 here. If I transpose this minus 5, it will come as plus 5 here. What will I have here? Minus 1x, which is equal to minus 15 plus 5, different sign. So if I subtract, I will get minus 10. Divide by minus on both the sides. So I will get x is equal to 10. See here, even here I will get the same thing. 15 minus 5 is 10. 3x minus 2x is x. In both the ways, I get the same thing. Is it clear, my dear children? It is not always compulsory that the variable should be in the left hand side. You can have it in right hand side also. What is the advantage of having this in the right hand side? See here, if I transpose this to right hand side, now I will have some negatives. I have to divide by negative symbol on both sides. To avoid that, I transferred 2x instead of 3x. Okay, you can do it in either way. Both is right. So I found the value of x to be 10. Is that the final answer? No. What is our objective? I have to find their present ages. What are their present ages? Shreya's present age is x and Arjun's present age is twice x. Isn't it? I have to substitute the value of x both here and also here. So I get Shreya's age to be 10 years and Arjun's age is 2 into x, which is 2 into 10, 20 years. Arjun age is 20 and Shreya's age is 10 years. Is it clear, my dear children? Whenever you have problems with ages that has present age 5 years ago, 5 years after, go in for tabulation to have a clear idea about what is the problem and what is our objective to be found. Okay, now shall we move to the next? Yes, dear. Here, the next question is, Shobo's mother's present age is 6 times Shobo's present age. Shobo's mother's age. See, this 6 times x is mother's age. And Shobo's present age is x. This is how we will start it. Now, Shobo's age 5 years from now. What does this mean? From now? From now, after 5 years. That's how they mean it here. Shobo's age 5 years from now will be future. So afterwards, 1/3 of his mother's present age. See, I'm talking about Shobo's age after 5 years and I compare it with his mother's present age. So be careful while you write equations. See here, in this table, I have written Shobo's present age as x and Shobo's mother's present age is 6x. And after 5 years, I have x plus 5. Here I will have 6x plus 5. Isn't it? But what have they said in the question? After 5 years, Shobo's age 5 years from now will be 1/3 of his mother's present age. Shobo's age is equal to 1/3 of his mother's age. 1/3 of his mother's age. Shobo's age is this now after 5 years. This is equal to 1/3 of his mother's present age. What is mother's present age? 6x. But many students will make an error writing here 6x plus 5. Okay, read the question again and again and then frame the equation. Is it clear, my dear children? They will confuse us. If I go by table method or any step-by-step method also, you should not get confused whether to have 6x or 6x plus 5. Read the question, clarify it and then write. Okay, it is 6x alone. They are comparing it with mother's present age. So, I took 6x. So, I will have the equation as x plus 5 is equal to 1 by 3 into 6x. If I cancel 1, 3, I will have 2, 3, 6, 2x. Then it's very simple. I am transpose this to right hand side. So 2x minus x, which is equal to 5. Here 2x minus 1x is nothing but x, which is equal to 5. I found the present age of Shobo's. Then his mother's present age will be 6x, 6 times 6. So 6 5s are 30 years. Is it clear, my dear children? Till you frame equation alone, you will have some difficulty. Even that, it will not be a difficult if you understand the question and make it clear. Okay, read the question sentence by sentence 2 to 3 times to understand it. Okay, don't understand in your own way. Try to understand what is given. Okay, now the question is, a grandfather is 10 times older than his granddaughter. We have two people here, grandfather and granddaughter. Now, your grandfather and yourself, like that. He is also 54 years older than her. So, what is the difference in their ages? 54 years. Find their present ages. This is very simple. No need to make it complicated. Just have it as granddaughter's age is x and grandfather age is 10 times 6. And they have the difference in their ages to be 54. Which is bigger number? 10x or x? Yes, 10x. So, if I subtract now 10x minus x, it should be 54. Or I can say grandfather's age is granddaughter's age plus 54. You can have it in either way. Both will lead to the same answer. So 10x minus x get transposed. We get 9x is equal to 54. X is equal to 54 divided by 9. 1 9 is 9. 6 9s are 54. So what is the present age of granddaughter? Yes, that girl, small girl. She is of just 6 years old. And what about that grandfather's age? He is 6 times granddaughter's age. Sorry, 10 times, not 6 times, 10 times. So, 10 into 6. 10, 6 are 60 years old. I believe even your grandfathers will be more than 65 or 70. Nearly they will be around 70 or 60 maybe. Okay, children. Take care of your grandfathers, grandmothers, and this is a very nice chance, good chance for you all to enjoy with all these people, share their experiences, how they came up in their life, what are the difficulties they faced as you are now facing in this corona situation. Talk about many things. Okay, how was their life? It was completely different from what we are having now. Okay, have a good knowledge. Try to enjoy all these shutdowns and you will not get in your lifetime such a very long gap away from the school. Okay, though we are away, we are going ahead with our learning process. Okay, children, take care. Take care of your parents, grandfather, grandmother and all the elders at home and stay safe and stay healthy. Bye-bye.